Controlling microgrids is essential because it allows to keep the system stable. Control makes possible to optimize power generation and consumption, considering external factors, such as market prices. In this video, we will talk about hierarchical control in microgrids, and we will see what are some of the different control strategies that can be used. You will learn what is the role of local, internal, and upstream control in microgrids, and how these three levels are combined in the hierarchical way. Then, we will address different control strategies that are generally implemented in microgrids. Among them, we're going to distinguish between grid-forming and grid-feeding strategies. We have seen that traditional control is hierarchical, and it is divided into primary, secondary, and tertiary control. A hierarchical control can also be implemented in microgrids, however, with some differences. Let's start describing it from the bottom. At the lowest level, where distributed generation, storage, and load are present, local control is responsible for the inner loop, outer loops, and the implementation of drip control. This type of control is implemented in the power converters that interface the different components to the distribution grid. At the second level, the microgrid central controller acts over the internal control. Here, the main goal is to adjust the reference points of the distributed generators in the microgrid. Also, the internal control manages synchronization between the microgrid and the external grid. When the microgrid is in grid-connected mode, at the top level, we find the upstream control. The distribution management system is responsible for this control level, and it mainly addresses the exchange of power between the microgrid and the external grid, taking into account electricity market and regulatory signals. Here, we can see an example of the implementation of hierarchical control in a distributed generation system. Local control acts on power electronics interfaces that connect generators, loads, and batteries to the microgrid bus. The control that acts on the power converter here, a DC to AC inverter, is based on voltage or current. On the very high level, upstream control provides the unit with active and reactive power set points, considering market and price signals retrieved from the transmission system operator, or TSO, or the distribution system operator. At this level, control is responsible for the optimal power flow in the microgrid. For example, it is possible to determine if it is more economically beneficial to sell power to the main grid or to store it. On an intermediate level, internal microgrid control adjusts the active and reactive power set points. This fast and accurate control has the aim of detecting and counteracting grid instabilities. At the lowest level, local control is implemented internally in a distributed generator in a decentralized fashion. Local control is the main responsible for controlling active power and reactive power in microgrids. The value of the three-phase currents and voltages are retrieved from the grid and sent to the controller. A distributed generation unit might provide extra ancillary services to the microgrid. Inertia emulation is one of the typical ancillary services, as well as power oscillation damping, supportive islanding operation, and power quality issues. Various control strategies are adopted to create a microgrid. It is possible to identify two types of distributed generation control, grid forming and grid feeding. Grid forming types fall into two groups: communication-based and non-communication-based control schemes. Among communication-based control strategies, master-slave control is widely known, and it is an alternative to drip control. Drip control is a non-communication-based control strategy. In the next video, we'll see drip strategies in more detail. Grid feeding types are typically implemented using a synchronous reference frame, a stationary reference frame, and a natural frame. We have seen already that through a Clark-Park transform, it is possible to adapt a three-phase ABC signal into a stationary frame alpha-beta, and then into a rotating DQ frame. The DQ rotating or synchronous reference frame is used when proportional integral controllers, also known as PI, are implemented. A stationary reference frame alpha-beta is used to implement proportional resonant or PR controllers. Finally, natural reference frame ABC, three-phase, can be used for a wide range of controllers like hysteresis and deadbeat controller. The master-slave control strategy is a mature solution for the parallel operation of several distributed generations in microgrids. The master unit is represented by a grid-forming type, which dominantly controls the voltage and frequency of a microgrid. Grid-feeding units, called slaves, mainly follow the voltage and frequency imposed by the master unit, while trying to follow their active and reactive power set points. Moreover, both types of grid-supporting units can be connected to such microgrid in a flexible way. In any case, a supervisory control is needed to appropriately divide the power among all the units. The main advantages of the master-slave control strategy are its simplicity, being quite straightforward to implement, and its robustness. However, the system cannot be easily expanded, and the supervisory control is needed to always share the power in a proper way. Importantly, this control strategy relies on communication technologies, which give lower reliability due to uncertain communication links. To overcome all these problems, a multi-master control strategy is often proposed. So, in this lesson, we learn that the local control in microgrids can be implemented in a hierarchical way. It is usually divided into local control, internal control, and upstream control. Then we saw how these three layers are implemented in a power converter, what are the areas involved, and the microgrid parameters over which the different controls act. Next, we had a quick overview of the different types of grid-forming and grid-feeding control strategies. Finally, we learned that the master-slave control strategy is one of the most mature solutions for the parallel operation of distributed generators in microgrids, making use of grid-forming and grid-feeding units. Alternative solutions, such as multi-master strategy, have been also proposed in literature to overcome the inherent limitations of the master-slave principle. In the next video, we will go more in depth into the role and principles of the different power converters used in microgrid control.